I'm Dr. Stephanie Ameis. I work at CAMH and at the Hospital for Sick Children. I work with young people with Autism Spectrum Disorder and we're now conducting a research study to look at whether repetitive transcranial magnetic stimulation, which is a type of brain stimulation that's well tolerated and non-invasive, might be helpful for some of the thinking problems that people with Autism Spectrum Disorder experience. So the kinds of thinking problems that I'm talking about are thinking problems like shifting attention, focus, organizing, managing, planning tasks, and completing tasks.
My name's Raphael, and I'm here because I've tried just about everything. For me, it's like friends who are also have similar issues, bug you, girlfriends, all this stuff. Not knowing how to keep busy, spending money stupidly, realizing it as you're doing it sometimes or slightly afterwards. It's a mess. The whole thing's a mess.
When somebody comes into the study, they will meet with me initially and Dr. Ameis. They will do a brief clinical interview, 2 4-hour assessments, and then begin the rTMS sessions.
rTMS is a non-invasive brain stimulation intervention that has been approved by Health Canada for the treatment of major depression. What it does is it uses repetitive magnetic field pulses to stimulate specific areas of the brain.
Once the rTMS sessions begin, they come in for 4 weeks of 20 sessions, and we'll meet again after to do some follow-up assessments and another MRI.
I'm very open-minded. I've heard nothing but good things about people with depression with this therapy. I think it's just generally good all around.
So people that I've seen come in so far have been typically university students who are struggling with handing in assignments on time, getting to the classes on time, and just general organization. I've also seen a lot of individuals who are looking to find jobs and are struggling to maintain those jobs because of their lack of organization skills and time management.
I would hope that whatever I'm doing here helps a lot of people avoid a lot of bad things that happen to me. And things get better, not worse.
If a young person between the ages of 16 and 35 who has a diagnosis of autism spectrum disorder and experiences difficulties with organizing, planning, managing tasks in their everyday life, they can contact us here if they're interested in participating in our study.